This is the Pulse of St. Louis.
Welcome to the Pulse of St. Louis. I'm Shirley Washington. You know, former St. Louis Treasurer Tashara Jones made history when she was elected the first Black female mayor of the city of St. Louis on April 6th of this year. Jones assumed the office 14 days later, and she joins us now. Madam Mayor, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
So, as we said, you assumed office April 20th of this year. How are things going?
And I think things are going okay. Still getting used to being in this huge office here. But we're already keeping our campaign promises and making sure that we are listening to people and trying to meet people where they are.
Any surprises so far?
No, not really. I knew that going into this, it would be hard, a lot of hard work. I'm thankful for my staff who have shown up and shown out day in and day out, who are dedicated to making sure that we leave St. Louis better than we found it, and thankful for the cabinet members who and other city employees who work hard day in and day out to deliver services to our citizens.
So what would you say is your biggest challenge right now?
Our biggest challenge, obviously, is public safety. And we are trying to fix some of the historic wrongs that have existed, some of our broken systems, like our 911 system. Earlier today, I took a tour of our 911 facility and talked to the hardworking operators that answer our calls. And we remain committed to combining our 911 systems with police and fire and bringing them under the under SEMA, which is our emergency management agency, and really trying to make sure that we are deploying the right resource to the right call, and making sure that we can interject and put more different types of professionals in our public safety department. Because, and I heard this when I was listening in on calls today, when people call 911, they call for help, and it's our responsibility to deploy the right resource to the right call.
Are you also adding social workers to your staff that tends to play into this particular program and this initiative that you're talking about?
Yes, absolutely. With the approval of the new budget year, we're going to add 20 to 30 new social workers in our Department of Health and our Department of Human Services. We're going to try to help our unhoused, make sure we're paying attention to victim support services as people experience crime and trauma. And make sure that, again, we can deploy the right resource to the right call so people get the help they need and connection to the resources they need.
So, Mayor Jones, tell us, why is it important to add more social workers, especially as it relates to crime?
Well, we've seen in other cities that only 4% of what our police respond to is violent crime. And a lot of times when people call for call our 911 line, they're calling for help. And a lot of times that help can be from social workers and other licensed professionals. Our cops and clinicians program that's been running since February has diverted people from going to the emergency room, as well as people from entering our criminal justice system. So we wanna make sure that we're deploying the right resource to the right call and freeing up our officers to do the work that they were trained to do in our academies. Having different types of professionals answer calls frees up our officers to do the work that they were trained to do.
So the coronavirus, of course, is top of mind and has been for a while now. What are you and your administration doing to protect public health?
Well, with the passage of the first tranche of ARPA funds and direct relief, we are making sure that we're going to get another mobile vaccination unit and go out into communities and knock doors to bring mobile vaccinations to communities. A lot of times people don't have the transportation to come to us, so we're going to go to them. Also, we did a mandate for city employees. So by October 15th, every city employee has to be vaccinated. And if they choose not to, then they'll have to subject themselves to weekly testing until they choose to get vaccinated. You know, this is important to try to increase the number of people who are vaccinated. And as we are going into the fall, We're going to start having to get booster shots. My 74-year-old father got his booster shot just a couple of weeks ago. So we're going to make sure that we can increase our vaccination numbers and rates, especially in the Black community where there's a lot of vaccine hesitancy in my family as well. So I have been texting and calling all of my cousins to try to convince them to get vaccinated, giving them the right information that they need, but also making sure that African-Americans and other people of color are not or don't continue to be on the forefront of this disease. We catch this disease at higher rates than our white counterparts, and we want to make sure that we can bring down those numbers.
And then, Mayor, what are you hearing from people in terms of why they are hesitant to get the vaccine?
There's just a lot of misinformation out there. And the one thing that I hear the most is they approved this vaccine too soon. Well, you know, they have been researching the mRNA vaccine for decades, and COVID-19 is not a new disease. You know, it started with COVID-1, and this is COVID-19. So I think that, you know, there's a hesitancy about what's in the vaccine, but, you know, when you go to the hospital for help, you don't ask, you know, what's in that aspirin or what's in that Tylenol. You know, these are FDA approved vaccines, and they are safe for people to take. So we just have to continue to combat the misinformation that's been out there about the vaccine and its efficacy and its safety.
So let's talk about the federal COVID recovery grants. What's the latest in regards to distributing those grants?
So we're working hard to get this money out in the community. As you know, we just approved $153 million in direct aid. That includes $500 checks for about 10,000 families. So now we're in the process of getting our RFPs out, because there is a process that we have to follow in City Hall that makes sure that we are transparent and follow the RFP process. So we're doing that right now. We are working with our Department of Health to get our mobile vaccination sites up and get a new mobile vaccination unit. We're doing RFPs to the Department of Human Services so we can provide services to our unhoused, and also developing intergovernmental agreements where we can so we can get this money out in the community as fast as possible.
So during your campaign, Madam Mayor, you vowed to close the workhouse. What is the latest on that effort?
Yeah, so in June, we were able to empty out the workhouse and put all of our detainees in one facility. However, we are also trying to fix a facility that has not been kept up for the last decade or more. So we inherited a facility that needs a lot of work. Recently, we had to move several detainees back to what we call the CJC Annex in the back of the workhouse, of what the current facility that you're showing. And those pods are identical to the pods that are currently in the CJC. So we call it the CJC Annex. And we are trying to fix the locks, but the locks is not the only issue. It's also an issue about culture and making sure that our officers are safe, and as well as our detainees are treated with dignity and respect.
So, Mayor, St. Louis is welcoming refugees from Afghanistan to the city. Do you know at this point how many have arrived and how many refugees the city can accommodate?
We don't yet know how many have arrived. I think I saw on recent news that, you know, several families have arrived so far. So we're working with the experts here who are experts in refugee resettlement, like the International Institute and Mosaic. So we are working with them to make sure that we can find housing or temporary housing, maybe in hotels for our families that are arriving here, collecting items from people to make sure that they have clothes and toiletries. So there's a list at the International Institute of people wondering what they can donate, because a lot of times these families are arriving just the clothes on their back and their identification paper. So we're working with all of our nonprofit partners to make sure that we provide a welcoming environment for our resettling families.
And so let's talk about the economy, Mayor Jones. What are you and your administration doing to help boost the economy in the St. Louis area, specifically in North St. Louis?
So we just hired a dynamic executive director of the St. Louis Development Corporation. His name is Neil Richardson, and he comes to us from U.S. Bank, where he's been doing this work on the U.S. Bank side, on the private side. And he is committed to economic justice, just as I am. And so what you'll see in the future from SLDC is a more outward-facing organization, because we realize that economic development is not just about bricks and mortar, it's also about people and how we connect people to resources, how we connect people to living wage jobs, how we have community benefit agreements within our development agreements. Because when we make an investment of our tax dollars to for developers to build new facilities or rehab our existing buildings, we want to make sure that St. Louis, the St. Louis government is an active partner when we are investing our tax dollars in the forms of tax abatements, either sales tax or tax incremental financing, increment financing for those projects. And so Neil and I and others in my administration have been hard at work, working with our developers to make sure that we not only build great facilities, but we connect people to living wage jobs, that we have MOUs with our school district to make sure that there is a career path for our graduating seniors, and really bring our economy back.
St. Louis Mayor Tashara Jones, thank you so much for your time. We appreciate you being here.
Thank you for having me.
And straight ahead on the Pulse of St. Louis, Harrisville State University has a new interim president. We'll meet her after the break and find out what she's doing to move the university forward. Stay with us. We are back in a moment.